Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to create this simple steel structure in SOLIDWORKS with the help of weldments features. I hope you like it. So let's see how to use a structural member. We will see many features like a structural member, end cap, gussets, weld beads. I hope you like it. So let's see how to make this one. This is the steel frame we are going to make with the help of SOLIDWORKS weldment tools. So the basic structure size is 750 by 100 millimeter rectangle. Then there is a pillar 500 millimeter long, and there is a vertical square bar, and that is 200 millimeter 45 millimeter. So first we will make frame, then we will assign this structure. This is 80 by 80. Then at the bottom there is a flange 120, 120, 10 millimeter. Okay, let's do it later. So here you can either choose, first right click, tab, click on weldments. See, weldment environment. Now click 3D sketch. Now first I'll choose here top plane. I'll select here center rectangle. Now see, it's moving perfectly. So this 750, press tab. And this length is 1000 millimeter, enter. Now that's it. Let me choose here line. And I'll select any one edges like this one. Go vertical length, let's say this is the 500 millimeter, enter, right click, exit. Now see, it is rotating like this. So simply click this one and you have to assign one direction. So which direction you are going to assign this one? Z axis. Look, now the things are perfectly aligned. Okay, even though you can delete and separately you can assign the dimension. Again I'll choose the line, I'll connect from here to this edge, and the distance 200 millimeter, this angle 45 degree. That's it. Now simply exit. Now if you entered weldment tools, structural member, first you need to define the standard. So we will go ISO standard, square tube. Now size here, we are going to choose 80 by 80 into 5 millimeter thick. Now there are multiple, if you are going to choose one plane, so keep in one group. If you are going to take other taper or any other plane, create new group. So in first group, I'll choose 1, 2, 3, 4. Now see, by default, it's meter. See the joints, apply corner treatment, it's meter. But in every corner you can change it. Just simply select this red pink spot. See, I'll choose this one, let's say end butt. Okay, now look, it's changed. Now let's apply this. Now here I'll choose end butt 2. Say okay. Now this relax in this in between these two frames. The same thing, let's apply here, this one, okay, this one. So individually we can edit the corner treatments. If you are going to apply here, it will apply in all corner together, okay. Now let's click new group, because this is in another plane. So I'll select this one. Again, I'll choose new group and I'll choose this one. See, this is little tapered. So we will change angle. If you come down here, you will find alignment, rotate angle 45 degree. Now let's just observe. Oh, that's perfectly, say yes. Look, let me hide this all. Now next, make this flange 120 10 millimeter thick. It is not shown, but okay. Now there is one end cap also, 2.5 the distance from top edge, corner fillet 10 millimeter, and there is hole 10 millimeter and thick distance 10 millimeter also. Okay, then there is one rib, a gusset 100 by 100, 20 20, and this is also 10 millimeter thick. So I'll select this face, sketch, center line, and I'll connect this center point to this center point, so that we will get a center point, center rectangle. Now see, this is, there is a midpoint, 120, tap 120, enter. Now select all, fillet 10 millimeter. Okay, say yes, yes, yes. Circle, if you are going to drive 10 millimeter, enter. If you check by default, it's perfectly aligned on 10. Now let's apply one construction line, vertical and horizontal, so that we can mirror this one. How we will do this one? Just hold shift key, select this line, circle, and this line, click mirror entity. Now see, it's mirror. Again the same thing we will repeat. I'll choose both the circle and this horizontal line, click mirror entity. See, go to feature and choose extruded boss base, and keep length 10 millimeter. See, end condition blind, thickness 10 millimeter. Say yes. Okay, now this one is finished. Let's see end cap. End cap, I'll choose this one. See, thickness 5 millimeter. Now there is a thickness ratio. If you will keep 0, see, it will move end to end, but there is 2.5, so 0.5 millimeter we will keep ratio, so it will be lies on center of this profile or this thickness. Corner radius 10 millimeter, because the outer one is 10 millimeter. Say yes. See, now let's apply gusset at this corner, gusset. Now here we will choose this profile, 100 120. Here I'll choose both side thickness 10 millimeter, mid sides I'll choose these two faces. Now you will see, if you change direction, let's say profile locate at end point, see, it moves, but we will keep at center. We don't need even offset also. If you choose offset, let's say 10 millimeter, see, it moves, reverse, but unchecked, and we will keep as it is. See, it is located at center. Now one more thing, weld bead. Now path one selected, I'll choose here smart weld selection. If I'll, you will see this pencil cursor, I'll move, drag from here to here. See, these two edges selected. Here selected faces, 6 millimeter bead size we will keep, and tangent propagation selection both side. See, both side is going to choose from length, even though length also you can change, what you don't like, or you can change simply from here, let's say 13. Say okay. Now go to view, hide and show and click here weld bead. Okay, now see, in both sides you will see the bead. Again we will apply one more time. I'll select this and I'll choose this one. See these two faces selected. This time everything we will keep both sides, but comes intermittent weld. See here the gap between two weld, gap and weld length. This is the weld length, this is the gap. Weld length, let's say 10 millimeter. See, okay, we actually come down. Now see here, it's 10 millimeter and gap we suggested 5 millimeters. Say yes. Look. So this is how we applied. In the same way, you can apply weld bead at all corners. So let's finish our job. Now we applied all the things. Now let's go to feature mirror. I'll choose front plane, bodies to mirror 1, 2, 3, 4 and this end cap. Say yes. Again choose mirror, this time right plane, bodies to mirror 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Don't forget to end cap. Now all the bodies and everything we selected. Wow, that's, we finished. Now right click, edit material. For a structural steel we will use ASTM A36 steel, 250 yield strength, apply, close. See, if you go to evaluate, choose mass property, and here you will find the mass and volume of this structure. So this is the simple tutorial how to use weldmen tools and create a simple structure in SolidWorks. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.